Hi everybody, today is Hatha. My name is Emma and we'll be doing a practice that really focuses on our hips and heart and getting our spine moving in all directions. So blocks aren't a bad idea to have today. If you don't have blocks, a book or some water bottles, anything to kind of lift, give a little lift is great. And we'll meet in a comfortable seat on our mats. Coming to a seat, get yourself settled in, maybe rocking side to side, forward and back. Root through your sits bones a little bit actively and allow your sacrum to root towards the ground. So you might feel your low belly engage as you do this. Sit up a little bit taller, feeling the crown of your head reach towards the sky. You might let your gaze soften or your eyes close as you start to take a couple of big rolls with your shoulders. Inhaling them up and exhaling to send them down and back. Begin to connect your movements to your breath, and then as you begin to settle into stillness, really connect with your breath. Belly expand, chest lift, collarbones rise with your inhales. And everything releasing, contracting, softening with your exhales. You might feel yourself grow a little taller with your in-breath and relax a little bit more deeply with your out-breath. Beginning our practice today with just a few moments of stillness, a little bit of mindful awareness of our breath and body. Letting go of anything that might be pulling our thoughts in a different direction, whether that's a worry or something happening in your immediate environment. Setting that aside for the next few moments. Take three breaths together to start practice. Begin by taking a big inhale through your nose, pausing at the top of your inhale, releasing a long, smooth exhale out your mouth. When you reach the base of your inhale, or your exhale, excuse me, breathe in again, taking a big inhale. Long sigh, exhale. And one more time, full breath in. Maybe the deepest breath you've taken yet. And release with a sigh. Beautiful. Begin to blink your eyes open or refocus your gaze. And we'll move through a few seated cat-cows. Inhale to send your heart forward, create space in your collarbones as you knit your shoulder blades together on your back body, gaze up, and then exhale, curling chin to chest, create space between your shoulder blades. Moving with your breath, kind of playing with flexion and extension of your spine. Take one or two more breaths in your seated cat-cows. Then we'll inhale to sit up tall in our central seat. And with your next inhale, reach your fingertips out and up. Exhale to press your palms away and push with the base of your hands as you release down. Nice. Inhale to flip your palms so you're scooping up air. Gently touch your fingers above your head. Exhale, flip your palms, press away. Again, inhale, reaching up, fingertips touch. Maybe your gaze follows. Exhale to press down and away. Inhale, fingertips reach. Exhale, this time our right hand will plant rooting through your left sits bone. Inhale, fingertips and gaze come back to center. Exhale, left hand plants along your left hip, arcing to the left. Weight equal in your sits bones. Inhale brings you back to center. Catch the other side again. Exhaling to arc to the right. Inhaling to center. Exhaling to arc to the left. Beautiful. Inhale to center. This time we'll take a twist. So with our exhale, we'll bring our hands out to this cactus shape as we turn from our navel to the right. Inhale back to center, fingertips reach. Exhale, arms cactus as we spin to the left. Inhale to center. Maybe your gaze follows your fingertips. And then exhale, opening wide, sending your elbows away from each other as you twist. Nice job. We'll round this out, finishing with a twist to our left. And then inhale back to center. Reaching through your fingers, long spine. Exhale to roll over your shins and make your way to your tabletop pose. Stacking your wrists under your shoulders, knees under hips. Spread your fingers wide, press through the pads of your fingers. And really engage your core here, sending your belly button up to your spine, pressing a little more actively through your shoulders. Send your right leg back behind you and lift your heel off the ground so it's about hip height. Dial your toes so they're facing towards the ground. Keep that engagement through the trunk of your body. Option to stay here or float your left fingertips out in front of you. And we'll just pause in a hold here. Feeling our bodies build up a little bit of heat in this static shape. Taking three more breaths, wrapping our outside ribs inward and creating as much space as we can between our heel and our fingertip. One more deep breath in. Exhale, float your palm, float your knee back to the mat. You might sway your hips side to side or take some big circles with your hips. Using the next one or two breaths to kind of refresh, shake things out. And then we'll set up in our strong table. Send your left leg back behind you. Heel lifts to hip height. Strong core, strong shoulders. Maybe your right fingertip floats up too. Finding this hold. And breathing here. Drawing your belly button to your spine, creating space between your shoulders and your ears. One more deep breath in. Exhale. Come back to table. Maybe you wag your tail side to side, take those hip circles. And then as you're ready, step back to your pose. Really engaging through your core, finding that same strong shape through your shoulders and hands as we did in our table. Drawing our elbows and thumbs towards each other. And then we'll make our way to our bellies. Option to stay with toes lifted or lower your knees to the ground. Inhale to shift forward, exhale to lower. Keep your elbows close to your low ribs, releasing your full body to the mat at the same time. Inhale peels you up to cobra. Exhale to release. Take a few more of these, flowing with your breath. Inhaling to roll your spine up. Exhaling to release. Feel your back body working here. Beautiful. With your next exhale, press through your palms, returning to table, just long enough to stack your hips over your knees, and then we'll walk our fingertips towards the top of our mat. Option to tent them, so you melt your heart towards the ground. Maybe your chin comes in contact with the ground. Maybe your forehead comes into contact. Maybe nothing does. Just inviting a big opening in our shoulders. And in this shape and every shape, listening to what your body needs. moving away from strain and discomfort, and finding that place where we're both building strength and finding a place to relax. With your next inhale, walk your hands back towards your knees. You might take a few cat-cows, or again, shake your hips side to side. Inhale to step your right foot forward between your hands. We're coming straight to our low lunge. So pause a moment. Make sure that your right ankle is directly below or slightly in front of your right knee. Square both of your hips to the top of your mat. Lift up to the middle finger of each hand, finding length in your spine, and then inhale to reach your fingertips out and then up, rising up to your low lunge. Hug your legs towards your midline and hug your front heel towards your back knee. Beautiful. With your next inhale, take a hold of your left wrist with your right fingertips. Breathing a leap, and then exhale to arc to the right. Inhale brings you back to center, and switch your grip. Left fingers take hold of right wrist. Inhale to find some length, and exhale to arc to the left. Inhale back to center, and exhale to plant your hands around that front foot. And step it back, medium table. Inhale your left foot in between your hands, setting up for low lunge. Engaging your legs, sending your thighs towards each other, left heel towards your right knee. Find some length in your spine as you rise to your middle fingers, and then inhale, fingertips towards the front of your mat, and then up to the sky. Beautiful. Two or three more breaths here in stillness. And then when you're ready, right fingertips wrap around left wrist. Inhale for length. Exhale, arc to the right. Inhale to center. Left fingertips wrap around right wrist. Inhale for length. Exhale, arch to the left. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, hands plant. Step your left knee back. Walk your hands about a palm print forward. Tuck your toes. We're coming to our first down dog of the day. So pause as we make our way there. You might pedal your feet out slowly. You might drop your hips to one side and then the other. You might shake your head yes and no. As we find our way to our down dog, keep your hands about a shoulder width distance apart. Roll your biceps up towards your ears as you press actively through your thumb and pointer finger. Keep your feet about hip width distance apart and roll your inner thighs towards each other. Knees can be bent any amount. Inhale your gaze up to the top of your mat. Exhale, take a bend in your knees, step walk or hop to the top of your mat, forward fold. Option here to stay in stillness or maybe pedal your knees out, one and then the other. Maybe sway side to side. Listening to what your body needs in the shape. Inviting in whatever opening, loosening, elongating of hamstrings, low back and spine that your body's ready for in this moment. With your next inhale, we'll lift up halfway, pressing our thighs to the wall behind us. Fingertips slide up our shins as we come towards a flat back. Navel drawing towards the spine, long neck. Exhale to release. We'll find that shape again. Inhaling for a flat back, stamping your shoulder blades on your back body. Exhale to release. One more time. Inhaling, halfway lift. Exhale to release. Gentle bend in your knees. Inhale to rise to standing. Let your arms sweep out and up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale to reach out and up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale for our half lift. Exhale, hands plant. Step directly back to your down dog. Deep breath in through your nose. Deep breath out your mouth. Inhale your right leg high. Take a bend in your knee and stack your right hip on top of your left. Maybe you take little circles with your ankle. And then exhale to square your hips. Step your right foot forward. Lower left knee to the mat. Inhale, rise up to low lunge. Maybe you heel toe your right foot forward slightly, coming to a little bit deeper shape this time. And with your next breath, we'll find our twist. So exhale your left hand down to the mat or a block. As you reach your right fingertips to the sky, option to keep your right hand here, or maybe release it to the base of your skull, helping kind of press your hip, your ribs to the sky, so helping kind of aid in that twist to the right. Exhale to release. Fingertips frame your front foot, tuck your left toes, rise up to high lunge. Beautiful. Squaring your hips, relaxing your face and jaw. Inhale to find length in your spine. Exhale, hands come together, fingers interlace, deepo fingers as we arc to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale to arc to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to release. Hands both plant to the inside of your right foot. Walk your right foot towards the right upper hand corner of your mat. Lizard pose. Option to stay lifted on your left knee or release it down to the mat. Option to stay lifted on your palms. Or you can find a block or two and lower yourself down to your forearms on a block or straight to the mat. Whatever feels best in your body, listening to your breath and really tuning into the sensations that you're feeling here. As always, moving away from sharp pain and discomfort and inviting in softness with your breath cycles. With your next inhale, begin to come back up on your palms if you're on your forearms, and heel toe your foot back towards your midline. Fingertips plant, spreading your hands wide. Send your right leg back, three-legged dog. Exhale, right foot plants. Inhale your left leg up to the sky. Take a bend in your knee. Stack your left hip on top of your right. Maybe you find those little circles with your shoulder, with your ankle. And as you're ready, square your hips back to the mat. Step your left foot forward, right knee lowers. Inhale to our low lunge. We've been here before. Feeling it out on this side. Maybe you stay right here. Maybe you heel toe your left foot towards the top of your mat just a little bit more. Sinking into the shape. Nice job. With our next exhale, we'll move to our twist. Right hand plants to the inside of your left foot, opening through your left arm. Left arm might stay where it is, or maybe hand comes to the base of your skull. You open, twisting a little bit more, spinning your ribs up to the left. With your next exhale, release your hands, frame your left foot, come to the toes of your right foot. Inhale, reach out and up, high lunge. Pausing here for two or three breaths. Then inhale to find length, lifting through your fingertips. Exhale, find steeple fingers and arc to the right. Inhale your way to center. Exhale to arch to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to lizard. Both hands come to the inside of your left foot. As you send your left foot out to the left and up to the top of your mat. Right knee can stay lifted, or maybe it releases to your mat. You could stay right here. This might be a lot of sensation. You might add a little bit more by lowering down to your forearms on a block or possibly the floor. Take about three more breaths here. And with your next inhale, begin to rise up to your palms and send your left foot in between your hands, framing your hands, and then stepping your left leg back, three-legged dog. Nice job. Exhale to come to your down dog. Noticing what's happening in your body. Feeling anything that's changed, anything that might have shifted. And we'll inhale our right leg up to the sky again. Exhale, step it forward between your hands. Step your left foot in about a third of the way, grounding through your whole foot. Straighten through your right leg. Maybe find some blocks or come to our pyramid pose. So we'll lift up halfway. So find that same flat back, long spine, and square hips as before. And then exhale to fold forward, lowering your forehead towards your shin. Breathing to the spaces where you're getting the most feedback in your body. Inhale to lift up halfway. Space between your tailbone and the crown of your head, and then exhale to fold one more time. With your next inhale, lift up halfway, press off your left toes, and come to a forward fold at the top of your mat. Inhale to rise to standing. Your arms sweep out and up. Exhale, interlace your hands behind your back. And inhale to find some length in your spine. Exhale to fold forward, keeping your hands interlaced. If that feels okay. If you're feeling a lot of tightness in your shoulders, you can always keep your palms down by your low back. If you'd like to deepen the stretch, you can invite them up to the sky or overhead any amount. Release your hands and inhale to a flat back. Exhale, step directly to your down dog. Inhale your left leg up to the sky. Exhale to step it forward between your hands. Pyramid pose the other side. Step your right foot in about a third of the way. Find blocks. Square your hips to the top of the mat. Straighten through your left knee without hyperextending it. And inhale to find a flat back. Exhale, release. Forehead towards shin. three or four breaths here. Inhale, half lift, extending through the spine, and exhale, fold again. With your next inhale, lift up halfway, and then step your right foot in, coming to your forward fold. Inhale for your half lift. Exhale. Set props off to the side. Hands plant. Step back to last. Down dog of practice today. When you arrive here, take a deep breath in through your nose. Deep sigh out your mouth. And soften your knees towards the ground. Sit back on your heels. Bring your legs out in front of you. Step them about mat's width distance apart. And bring your hands behind you. Inhaling to send your chest towards the front of your mat. And then release your knees to the right and to the left. This is a nice twist. Nice stretch through the shoulders. Opener through the chest, and a little massage for the low back and glutes. Beautiful. After you've had your fill of your little twists, you can even things out and wind down. Bring your feet together and extend your legs long in front of you. Hug your right knee into your chest. Give yourself a little squeeze. Inhale to sit tall and send your left arm up to the sky. Exhale, twist, wrap your left arm around your right leg and send your right arm behind you, almost acting like a support for your spine, helping you sit up a little taller. Keep your left toes flexed and send your gaze over your right shoulder. Gaze to the horizon, chin parallel to the ground. Check in with your breath. With your next exhale, unwind, come to center. And extend your right leg long. You might kind of shake out your knees or let your toes rock to one side and then the other. And then when you're ready, sit tall again. Flex through your left or your right foot as you draw your left leg in, planting the sole of your left foot on the inside of your right thigh. Inhale, right fingertips to the sky, long spine. Exhale to wrap them around your right leg, left hand, or excuse me, left leg, left hand also comes behind you. Gaze maybe over your left shoulder. Letting your breath start to even out, start to smooth out. And with your next exhale, unwind. Coming back to center. Keeping your legs a little shake. And then drawing the soles of your feet together. You might shift your weight side to side, sit up tall, and bring your hands to the outsides of your feet, thumbs to the soles of your feet. We'll inhale to lengthen our spine and fold forward with a long spine first, and then option to take a little curl in your back, tucking your chin to chest. Rise back up, draw your we'll end where we began today in our comfortable seat. Root through your sit bones, sit up tall. We'll inhale our fingertips wide and to the sky. Gaze following your fingertips as they touch above your head. Exhale to press away. Inhale, fingertips lift, gaze lifts. Exhale to press away. Really connecting your breath to your movement. Inhale, fingertips touch. And exhale, draw your palms together, hands at heart center. Take a deep breath in through your nose. Release a deep sigh out your mouth. Thank you so much for making space in your day to practice a little bit of hatha yoga, to move your body, to tune into your breath, and to do something kind for yourself. Thank you.